Hello everyone, welcome back to Neurovisor. And I have a new mic, so hopefully now everything's better. I will start with the Dash class again. Let's go with this one. Track radius for crystals been increased. I feel like now getting crystals from further away than before. Maybe that's just me. Shit on this screen. I mean, I did choose the level like 4 difficulty. Even though I didn't even die, you know, firing right in my face. Also, something I'd like to see in the game is that, you know, that the game drops, the equipment drops you get, not talking about weapons, only equipment here, should be more likely to be usable for the class that you're using, rather than any other class. So for example, now I'm playing Dash class, it would be good if Dash class items would be more likely to drop than, you know, Fortress and Rampage class items. Maybe that would make the game more easier, but then again you could also just, you know, reduce the chance of rare equipment dropping, but, you know, make it more likely that you get something you can actually use. Because oftentimes it's like, you get a rare, say core and propeller early, right? And then you don't get anything that's even half as good for a long, long time, whereas the game gets more and more difficult and you still have the same amount of HP. And then one super elite appears and you're just fucked. Rare gas, and the other one was a fast shotgun. Okay. I think we're done. Yeah, we are. Good. vision. Okay, let's drop everything else. EP generation is really good with what we have. I'm not going to give it up for that. Transport. No, here comes the good stuff. Guns. Handgun, no. Firecracker, no. Firecracker, no. Long flamethrower, no. Flamethrower, no. Pulse beam. Pulse shocker. How many firecrackers can we get on one level? One more. Okay. This one doesn't have very much DPS. So what do we have? A pulse beam. A pulse shocker. Fat shocker. This doesn't do very much DPS. Regular shocker. Rail gatling. So I think I'm gonna go with this one. I think we're not incredibly strong right now, but we did improve. Also, the pulse beam is now narrower. Oh, that's why we got a fat beam right now. Holy crap, this level is gonna be so small. Look at how quickly those crystals are stacking up. Splash plasma is dead. I just never used it, so that may be the reason why I thought at first it was a new weapon. Oh! And that was it for this level. Got some new stuff though. How much HP does this give? 53. No, I actually think I stick with what I have. This is better at everything, so why wouldn't I go for it? This is the most energy ever though. I think I wanna go with this, because big loot, or the biggest loot of any levels that we had on offer at least. And high difficulty, meaning that we should get a lot of stuff from the enemies we killed. No. No, 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 no. Get off me. Thank you. Full speed reactor. What? Another one? You really have to adapt your way of shooting with the fat beam, as it uses so much energy, but it can also kill enemies very quickly, meaning that you only hold it down for just a little bit and then the enemy dies and then you let go. Oh, that's good. Again, or whatever you use to shoot. Because otherwise you're just gonna waste energy very, very quickly and you might run out. How many super elites can we have on one level? There we go. A holy grenade! Oh my god, that's gonna be so good. We have cleared out more than half the areas on the map, but don't have half the required crystals yet. Oh, that group of tanky guys was kind of scary. If I see anything that might scare me, I'm gonna pop the heal right away as opposed to waiting until I get hit again. Crystals to finish this level, but we should be fine at this point. Unless there's another super elite waiting around the corner, which could kill me. But it looks like there is not. Nope. Okay. Be awesome if we also had good other stuff for Fortress. I'll keep this for now. Sure. Let's see, do we have anything else that we may want to use? This is pretty good. Oh. Okay, this is even better. Except for the EP regeneration. It doesn't have very much at all. Always seems like the better tier cores have way less EP regeneration than just the common ones. This one would be really good. And what about transport? Oh, that's so good though. Okay, you know what? At this point, I'm gonna change class. Because we have a propeller that gives us plus 47% speed. And that is really, really useful as fortress, because usually you're very slow. And this gives us 102 HP and 128 EP. Yeah, I think we go for it. Yeah, okay. I think let's just stick with what we have right now. And then. Okay. Beam of probing. How much is this? 494. Also uses a shitload of EP though. I'm just gonna go with this pulse beam. Bad beam. It's actually bad. Autogun. Flamethrower. Pulse beam. This is better than the one we are using. Shocker could also be useful. Oh yeah, we have a holy grenade. Why am I thinking about what I'm using in the secondary slots? We have a holy grenade. There we go. Oh yeah, damage has been nerfed. Because I remember one time I picked up a holy grenade at like the second level and it did, what, 1300 damage? On impact, this on shot, and this only does 900. I mean, it's still a lot, don't get me wrong, but no, far less. Okay, let's just drop everything else and move on. Let's go with the right choice again. Is this the right choice? The pulse beam is doing great work. Also, we are maybe even slightly faster than we were as dash class, but we are a fortress now, and we have a lot more HP, and we have a shield. And this is good, it's really good. We also have so much EP now. Like that guy. And I like the holy grenade. It is kind of weird to use in a sense that it takes really long to get to an enemy. But once it lands, like, it does so much damage. Yeah, and it can clear out like 20 enemies at once if they're like close together. Okay, now like I will remember to use my shield eventually. At some point. During this round. Oh, okay. One for you, sir. And have one of those. And one of those. See, I did use my shield there. Intentionally. Energy, we can use it for longer until we need to recharge. Also, the last one did 494 DPS. This one is probably gonna do around 700 or 800. So, Vision, do we have anything that we can use? Not really. I think I want to replace my propeller with another one either. I mean, it doesn't have very much HP associated with it. But does have a very high speed. I could also go with the big chakra as my primary weapon. Which is probably not a bad idea. Because it does have like significantly lower EP consumption than the fat beam. Let's see what the difference in DPS is. 822. Oh my god. How much do we have now for 81? 578. Fuck it. And we're gonna stick with the holy grenade. Because it is our best secondary weapon right now. Small and cramped is what this level is gonna be. Why was he invisible for a second? Was that a rare mover or a rare reactor? As a reactor I'd be very happy about. Mover, maybe not so much because I can use it. Well, these little shots from the small enemies, I should just take. Speed things up. Wait, we already have enough crystals? That was an easy level though. Not difficult at all. Okay, I don't need that. Of course it was this. That's okay. Do we have anything else that we want to use? No. So, we're gonna fight our first boss this time. Or now. It's gonna be that guy. He's gonna be dead in a second. Because we're doing so much damage with our holy grenades. He didn't stand a chance. This is worse than what we have. And that is something we can't use. So, yeah, let's go with this one. The fat beam should still be good for here. Quite a while until we get back up, actually. The efficiency of regeneration is not that good on our reactor. There we go. Down we go. It'll be a long way. Wait, what? Did it die? No, they didn't. They don't die from one holy grenade, so need something stronger. grenades are so nice for shooting into a corner like this. Everything just explodes.
This was actually not as difficult
as I thought it might be. It wasn't indicated as a very high difficulty level, but still. Okay, nothing we can use as far as sensors go. This might be good. Yeah, but tell you what, let's drop everything else so far. Okay, so this gives us 102 HP and 128 EP. This gives us 127 HP but only 88 EP. Well, this one can go fuck itself because it's only giving us 66 EP. The question is this worth it? It does have a little bit better EP generation and it does have more bad HP, but it has less maximum EP. It also reduces the EP cost of our shield, but we're not using that very often, so I think we're gonna go with that. This makes us tankier and Fortress class is really all about tankiness. This gives us almost twice as much HP but no speed at all. That only gives us plus 14% speed. That's good though. That's what I was looking for. Get a pulse shocker. It could be pretty good. Oh, there's another better one here as well. Auto gun. You know what? Holy crap, that pull shocker is really strong. Auto gun. Big double shotgun. That's a nuclear rocket launcher. No, it's just way too inaccurate. Now, what do I use as my secondary weapon? We got the Holy Grenade, which does shitloads of damage. Actually, not even as much damage anymore for this stage. This does less damage on hit, but it shoots more than twice as often. Whereas this... I think we're gonna go with the big shotgun of Brother Corruption. So now we don't have a weapon that does just massive amounts of damage per hit anymore. Gotta keep that in mind, there's just no, you know, right click and kill that anymore. Excuse me? Can't get through there? Smaller guys die in one hit from the pulse shocker usually, but they get a good hit at least. Here? Got everything. No, there's one more area we haven't been to yet. One of these guys. And that's it. Alright, anything new that we want? No? I'm gonna say no as well. Actually, I'm gonna say yes, because it gives us so much EP regeneration. Dump all of these. Full shocker. Balanced double shotgun. Actually, it would be... Okay, we got another big shotgun here anyway. Plasma sword of lucky probing. Okay, so now we have even less flat or maximum EP, but a lot more EP regeneration. We should be good to make quite a lot out of the EP that we have. How did we take so much damage already? Oh my god, this is a huge level. I am fucked. Can't kill the enemies quickly enough. Did a lot of damage. Real gun. And that's a good thing that Fortress class knows, so that whenever he aims at me, I can just shield, and then when he shoots, I'll just deflect the shot and I won't take damage. Oh my god, now they're coming from the other side as well. Been holding back for quite a while, fellas. Can't hold it anymore. Can't hold back anymore. See, I would be dead right now if I didn't have self-repair. Because I used twice in this, on this level already, and that way I'm healthy, but without it I would just be dead. I'd be so fucked. No matter what other bios I take, I would be fucked right now. But what a big shot there. Oh my god, I'm running low on energy, which is bad. Okay, the super elite is down. We can do this. Nice and slow. Take him out one by one. There we go. Once we use her, we use her, and we got through. Whoa, okay. Now that was kind of scary. I'm not gonna lie. This should be fine. I'm gonna keep my distance so they can hit me. He hit me, it's not a big concern right now because my heal is back up and I can go a little bit lower before I need to heal. That being said, if I encounter a super elite, I'm gonna heal immediately. Please die. Okay, now I'm gonna heal. Please somebody die. Stuff here. I can't get through there. I'm too big. And this is such a long level. I I used my heal 3 times already on this level and it's almost back up again. That should tell you. With the cooldown that has, that should tell you how long this level is. Kimmy, I can't get through here either. Okay, I think we made it. I hate being chased by like very fast swordsmen. And yeah, well, that's exactly what I'm gonna get here as well. And none of them hit me. We even got a light rack, which is pretty nice. Okay, I'm gonna heal up again. Thank God the shotgun has a little bit of knockback. Because without it, we would have taken a lot more damage there. Of course, we can get through there, but not through the biggest gaps in history. That's something else over here. Bigger gap. And I think we're done. Holy crap, this was a tough level. What did we get? Did we get anything we can use? I mean, weapon wise, probably. As far as vision goes, no. Core. Yep, this one. Yep, that one. And oh, that's Rampage class anyway. 59 EP per second. Wow. Transport. Do we have anything here that we can use? Nope. I mean, sure, this gives us 130 HP rather than the, what, 74 that ours has? But it has 0% speed, so we're likely to take a lot more damage. Handgun, no. Light shocker could be good. Shotgun with firecracker. Pulse shocker could be good. Not better than the light shocker. I don't think I want this. There we go. That's one thing I want. Is there anything else? Handgun. Autogun. Grenade launcher. Light chopper. This does a good amount of damage. I think I'm actually gonna go with double shocker weapons, if that makes sense. Light Wrath in one hand and the other shocker in the other hand. Oh my god, this run is already 50 minutes again. Yeah, baby, that's how he kills stuff. Oh no, okay, he's one of those guys. Okay, again, pretty small level. Oh, save our energy for this guy. He didn't hit us there. Which is kind of surprising. We got a double beam. And that double beam is gonna be so good. I think I'm gonna go the double beam in one hand and the light rack in the other hand, unless we get something better for our second slot. Please. And a rocket launcher. Could be good. Double beam rocket launcher seems like a fairly strong combination. Oh my god. Well, it's only small now, don't worry. Right. Intermission and no. That's the first good sensor we've gotten in ages. Take none of these, not even this one. So our first weapon is gonna be the... Oh my god. This one's so strong. Big double beam of shooting. And then we have... Enhanced rocket launcher. Because a regular rocket launcher wouldn't be good enough, right? Good. Question is, can we get to the second boss? Probably, given the parameters of this level. How many more do you take? He's already hit 7 rockets. 8, 9, 10. And a little bit of double beam action. But holy crap, he was so tanky. Let's be honest, like, I got the strongest rocket launcher I could have at this point. And he ate 10 of those rockets. And then some more damage from the double beam. And then he died. That seems a little bit much, doesn't it? At this point in the game are just far too tanky. And there's another one. Three super elites on a level with the lowest possible difficulty. And each of them takes 500 years to kill. Much HP. Over 250. Gotta go with it. Okay, nothing we can use here either. Okay, nothing we want there. And we're gonna fight our second boss. Which is Probably where this run is gonna end. It's the same guy again. Actually, maybe not. Maybe it's not where this run is gonna end. Because we have so much HP. But then again, like I can't move out of the way. But that would take energy that I need for shooting and doing damage. We got a mini nuke out of it. Oh my god, it's so good. Don't want the real Gatling necessarily. Okay, now we're gonna die anyway. Let's face it. And also I want this run to end at some point, so you know, I can actually render and upload these videos. Because I gotta go to work in, you know, 1 hour from now. I haven't produced any videos yet. Oh goodness! Okay, I'm probably gonna die here. Let's just face it. This guy takes a pounding. Mini nail to the face. Already used my heal and I'm low on HP again, so yeah, not looking that good. Wait, he took a mini nuke and didn't die? Yeah, there I go. Game over. Hope you guys enjoyed this run. Leave a like or a comment if you did. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.